Hello, and welcome back to Battletech 3062, brought to you by Commando Gaming and Battletech Battles. Continuing our series right where we left off, I did a travel to a 4-star planet, and I was excited to find a 5-star assassination mission available. So this is definitely going to be high on the challenge bar. Hopefully we'll get some really good salvage out of this mission. So, let's jump into the action. I brought my heaviest mechs for this battle, but a 5-star mission is probably going to be pretty tough here. Let's see how it goes. Let's jump in and see how we fare. Alright, so we're in the Highlands, so heat is definitely something we have to watch. So we're supposed to assassinate an insurgent leader. All right, so we got some mechs on the scanner here. We got enemy catapult, an enemy roughneck, 70 tonner, and a 95 tonner. That looks like some good salvage here. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna start out with the targets where we can attack their rears. Obviously, so we're going to start out with our Firestar's got a great opportunity to hit this catapult in the rear, so let's do that. Alright, so the Roughneck is much less of a threat. He's probably going to go after our Firestarter, but our Firestarter has really high evasion. And the Roughnecks usually have ACs or missiles, so we're fine there. So we're going to keep our goal of engaging the most vulnerable target, and probably the biggest threat right now is this catapult. Again, we can get a rear shot on this catapult. Ooh. Bad miss there, but we got the engine. So that's a good start to this mission. Okay, so there's enemy reinforcements coming. So we've got at least 8 mechs. All right, where are the mechs coming from? Oh, we got a Warhammer. Okay. Good salvage there. Where are the enemy reinforcements coming from? So they're coming from the far side of the map. So right now we could just focus on these initial targets. We're going to try to isolate one enemy at a time. Since these guys are up here, we might as well focus on getting this Roughneck off the field as quickly as possible. Lots of firepower here on this Roughneck. Let's move up our grasshopper here. So we got 2 things we can do. Now, one thing is my grasshopper is armed with dual plasma rifles. So what we can do is we can do multi-target. We want to heat up this Warhammer if we can, because the Warhammer is going to run hot on this map. So we're going to shoot the plasma rifles at the Warhammer. Hope for a hit, and then hit the Roughneck with everything else. We missed with both of those shots on the Warhammer. At least we turned up the heat on the Roughneck. Primitive Banshee as our other target. Not too worried about the Banshee. So the biggest threat right now on the board is still that Warhammer. So let's try to get our Atlas to some cover. Yeah, didn't quite get to cover. Alright, and then we're just going to keep hitting this Roughneck. Roughnecks look intimidating, but... And they've got decent armor. Oh, is that 100? Alright, so that's 100 tonner up there. So that's our assassination target, which means we're going to get great salvage out of this mission. Going to be pretty aggressive here because we've got this Roughneck outnumbered. So we'll do some melee with our Firestarter. Keep really heating up that Roughneck. Oh, we got an internal explosion. Alright, the Roughneck is going to retreat because it's in bad shape. Oh, and it overheated. Do here. And use our sensor, our sniper here. Now I could finish off the Roughneck. I'm probably going to have to do that just because I want to take a mech off the board here, and the hit percentages are so high. We'll probably get a lethal, pilot lethal here, maybe. No. Thought that would have done a lot more. Let's go ahead and have our Grasshopper go in, see if he can finish off this Roughneck with some melee. See if we can finish off this Roughneck. We'll just save some ammo and heat here. There we go. Roughneck down. All right. Let's see if this Warhammer does. Goes after our Grasshopper. Grasshopper can handle it for a round or two. Here comes the Banshee. The Banshee just doesn't have a lot of weapons for its tonnage. Most Banshees are more bark than anything else. Alright, so let's move our Atlas into cover. Alright, best shot is on this Warhammer here. Let's actually use a precision strike here on the Warhammer. See if we can take out one of the legs. Not quite, but we did get some structural. All right, that 100 tonner is moving up. All right, so we're actually going to use melee attack with our Firestarter. Again, we're trying to get the heat up on this Warhammer. So So he can't use his weapons. Alright, that's a good start. The same hit percentage chance. Let's actually use our Marauder to start working on that Banshee a little bit. Because I have plans for this Warhammer now. So now we can move our Grasshopper, which, as I said, has two plasma rifles. So what I'd like to do here is just probably going to overheat a little bit, but it's going to be worth it if I can shut down this Warhammer's weapons. So let's do a called shot. See if we can hit him with our plasma. There we go. So now the Warhammer's overheating, so it's going to have a hard time using its weapons at this point. We have our Orion also hit the Banshee here. Just trying to break down some of that armor on the Banshee. Hundred tonner is probably going to be in range and around, so we're going to have to keep that in mind. Be nice to get rid of one of these mechs before that hundred tonner comes into play. Ooh, hard hit from that Banshee. It hit on just about everything, but we got plenty of armor. We'll be fine. See, the Warhammer can't do anything at this point because it's totally overheated. Have our Atlas also work on the Banshee. Definitely have to watch our heat here. All right, we got some structure exposed on the Banshee. Ooh, it's a Mackie. It's a relic. Mackie is not a mech that we probably use because it's ancient. Unless this has been refurbished. So we're actually going to let our Firestarter keep working on the Warhammer here. Alright. So the Warhammer isn't much of a threat right now because it's overheating. So let's actually take some targeted headshots at this Banshee just to see if we can get it out of this battle with a headshot. Oh, that's not a good start. Missed with our Gauss rifle. Even the best sniper misses sometimes. See, that Firestarter got desperate there, or the Warhammer got desperate, and now it's overheated. Alright, so we're actually gonna move our Grasshopper. I want to start putting it in a position where it could flank that Mackie. We're just going to focus on keeping this Warhammer overheated. Do some damage as well. Or just blow up the engine. That's fine, we're probably not going to need salvage on the Warhammer. Alright, that's those reinforcements. They're on the way. So, it's going to be in our interest to try to finish off these guys as quick as possible. Just going to have to hit this Banshee hard with everything we have. Atlas up here. Alright, we're actually going to do a targeted strike here. Let's go for the head, maybe we'll get lucky. Comes the Mackie. Now the Mackie's value is because it's going to be, it's a very unique mech to find. And it would be great to add to our collection. I don't think I would use it. Even though it's a 100 tonner, it's really old. I don't know how much I can do to improve a Mackie. Alright, so let's actually take our fire starter. See if we can start heating up this Mackie. Okay. Now we've tagged the Mackie. So can we, one thing we can do right now is start taking headshots at it. See if we can get lucky here. Alright, we got a head hit on the Mackie, that's good. Alright. Let's move up our Grasshopper. Have it go after the Banshee here. Alright, the Banshee's really overheating here. See if we can put an end to this Banshee. That's a lot of firepower. There we go, there goes the Banshee. stay out of the fire. Just pepper this Mackie a little bit. Oof. Good hits on our Orion there. We're going to have to make sure the Orion falls back to the rear. Keep meleeing the Mackie. Okay, so our sniper can get a good shot at the Mackie here. If we could get a headshot, as you can see, the head already has a fair amount of damage. So if we can just get one weapon to hit that head. There we go. Alright, so we got three parts of the Mackie. Quick draw coming up. All right, so what we want to do now is we want to be strategic about this. So we've got another enemy lance coming. Our Orion already has some damage, so we're going to pull our Orion back. And there's no reason, now that we destroyed the enemy target, the assassination target, for us to rush towards the enemy. And I don't want to evacuate because I want to maximize salvage here. So what we're going to do is we're going to reform our lance and set up a defensive line instead of charging towards the enemy. Probably in this area, so ideally we can get the enemy to come through us, through the fire, and hopefully overheat a little bit. That would be the best case scenario. At the end of the day, I want to destroy the enemy without taking as little damage as possible. So there's no reason for us to push forward and take damage when we can just set up a battle line and make the enemy come to us, because they will. There's a lot more than just this quick draw, because this is a five skull mission. Right, so let's take a couple turns here to set up exactly how we want to set up here. We want to do is we want to set up on the other side of this road, and force the enemy to come through this inferno and come to us. That's the best case scenario, especially with this map, because then the enemy is going to run hot because they have to get through this whole area that's on fire. So that's what we're going to do. See, that's a lot of heat the enemy's going to have to fight through to get to us. And that's completely to our advantage. Alright, there we go. We're going to set up our lance. Sensor locker on the other side. Put our sniper in the second level. All right, there's the quick draw. Moving our prime where we want it to be. All right, so the quick draws in the fire already. So we're actually going to move up our grasshopper. Got plenty of armor. And I can use our plasma rifle because the hit percentage is not good, but we might as well just shoot some medium lasers at this guy. Try to get him to come towards us. That's fine. Got plenty of long-range weapons to shoot at this guy with. Yeah, we'll just go ahead and use our MRMs here. Just trying to get him to come to us. Actually going to use a traditional sensor lock here. Alright, let's put our sniper to work now. Precision strikes. And we're just going to keep going for the head. Goes after the grasshopper. Totally fine with that. Now the quick draw is coming into the fire, so he's going to get overheated. And we're going to make that worse right now. Because we've got our plasma rifle. See if we can get a hit here. Just want to keep overheating this guy as much as we can. Alright, we got another enemy unit coming in. That's fine, totally fine. not use our precision strike here. We'll just hit him with everything we have. Now we've got an 80 tonner coming in. Is that an 80 tonner? Yeah, it might probably be a Victor. Since it shot a large laser, that would be my guess. That's a Victor. Got plenty of ammo here. Ooh, we hit on all three AC5 shots. So that was nice. Sketchy. Let's have Sketchy move up. Figure out what we're up against over here. Yep, a Victor. Thought so. Let's use the sensor lock on this quick draw again. For the head again. Actually, let's just go for the center torso. That should have finished him off. See, the quick draw was overheating. Stressed out. So all it had to do was. Alright, so we can actually hit this guy quick draw pretty hard with our plasma. There we go, there goes the quick draw. Alright, we still got three more enemies left, which is a great salvage opportunity. Another large laser. Okay. Alright, so we're going to be careful with our Orion because it already has structural damage. I still want it to be able to engage in the battle, which is good because it has a Gauss rifle. So we can still take Gauss rifle shots. Nice. Nice Gauss rifle shot there at long range. All right, let's see what the Victor does. It's going to keep going after the fire starter. Might already be having heat problems because it didn't shoot its large laser. All right. Let's move the Atlas up. I have no problem tanking with the Atlas here. Alright. Nice hit there on the Victor. Alright, this is pretty aggressive here on the Victor, but I also want to see what's up there. We got a grasshopper. Alright, so let's keep the heat going on the Victor. Keep in mind our melee, our evasion is still really high on the grasshopper. So if the Victor goes for melee, it's a low chance that they're going to hit him. In the meantime, we have a sensor, we have a tag on the Victor. So we can go for some headshots. got a half of a Victor left, a Grasshopper, and a Juggernaut. Ooh, interesting. We're going to have some tough salvage decisions to make here. Just took off the AC gun off the Victor. Very nice. And the Victor we're probably not going to want to get salvage off of, because we have so many better options right now. So just keep hitting that Victor. Juggernaut. Interesting. I don't think I've come across a Juggernaut before. And it's rare when I don't see a mech that I haven't fought before. So, that's interesting. Alright, let's press forward. See if we can finish off this Victor. Let's see what the Victor does. It might go for melee on our Firestarter, maybe? Yep. Ooh, lucky shot. Lucky shot. Alright, so our Firestarter. I could. Could go for melee here, but then the Firestarter would be very at risk. So let's actually, what we can do, not very often I use a precision strike with my scout, but if I take out the leg here, I thought that would take out the leg. Okay, we'll finish him off with our Marauder here. No need to do a precision strike. There we go. He should have checked at this point. No. That's actually a really experienced pilot not to eject in that scenario. Alright, so our Firestarter is definitely under a lot of stress here. So we need to move up everybody else, keep this guy distracted. I'm just going to finish off this Victor. There we go. Ejected. Alright, let's just take some long range shots at this Grasshopper. We have the advantage in a lot of ways here, so let's be smart about this. Still got plenty of rotary ammo, so we'll go ahead and take those shots. Hit 2 out of 3. Not bad. Alright, so our fire starter is in a bad way here, so we're going to sprint. Maximize that evasion. And let's just do a traditional sensor lock on this grasshopper. Pilot lethal damage would be really nice right here. So let's see if we can get this grasshopper. Not quite. All right, let's move up our grasshopper. And see if we could just overheat that grasshopper. Nice. Alright, our Orion already has structural damage, so let's keep him away in the back. He still has a Gauss rifle. Yes. That juggernaut's got 3 large lasers. All right, so this juggernaut is a 90-ton assault. It's definitely going to run hot. Let's see if we can do precision strike on one of the legs. Alright, they seem distracted, so I don't know if they're going to go after our fire starter. I think we're going to take the chance here, but we can distract that grasshopper, get a tag on it, took off one of its weapons, that's great. Keep moving up our sniper, good hit percentages on that juggernaut, but I'd like to finish off this grasshopper if we can. Alright, so what I'd like to do get our grasshopper in some cover. Move up our Orion a little bit. I think it's not it's far enough away that we can still not be at risk. Nice hit there on the grasshopper. Up. All hitting that grasshopper. Grasshopper's lost both arms now. Right, just keep hitting that grasshopper. Save our precision strikes, and we'll just really like that grasshopper to eject at this point. Wow, I thought it would eject for sure. Go ahead and use a precision strike. See if we can finish off this grasshopper. Oh, that really should have done it. Okay. Move up this grasshopper. Gonna save our plasma rifle ammo, but we'll go ahead and hit that grasshopper again. There we go, it ejected. Alright, now it's us against this juggernaut. Ooh, I was afraid of that. That juggernaut's large lasers are a bit of a problem. Let's move up our Atlas. Right, let's do precision strike here. Yep. Firestarter will go around the flank. Keep this guy distracted. Hopefully get a tag. There we go. Alright, now the fun begins. Can we get a nice headshot on this juggernaut? That round. Alright, we're going to be a little aggressive here, keep the grasshopper there, but what we're going to do is see if we can overheat this juggernaut. So it can't use all those large lasers. There we go. Gonna be able to use that trick once. Alright, and we'll just pepper him. Alright, let's move up the Atlas. Make it the Atlas a nice big target because it's got all of its armor. Let's see what he's gonna do. He's probably gonna shoot at the grasshopper. Really overheating. Our grasshopper can't take too much more of that. Ah, but he overheated. That's exactly what I was hoping for, actually. All right, he's panicked now. He's overheated. We've got a tag, and we're doing a precision strike. Chances of us hitting this head is pretty significant. Really thought we would have hit there. Alright, let's pull back. Grasshopper. Don't want to risk any serious damage. All right, we'll take another shot for the head. He could do is power up. All right. Going for the legs there. Either like to get a headshot or to get him to panic here. That's the best case scenario. He's in a very panicked state. We're going to be super aggressive here with our Marauder. Maximize our chances with one last headshot. See if we can get him in the head. There we go. Lethal damage. So we'll get three parts available for that. Oh, one? That's a ripoff. That is a ripoff. Okay, successful mission. We got minor damage to two of our mechs. Not too bad for a five skull mission. We should get some really good salvage here. I wouldn't really consider that a five skull, more of a 4.5 skull. Because the Banshee was factored in as a assault, but it's really not more than heavy in my opinion because of the firepower it brings. So we got a good payday. See, the Orion got a shot to the center torso there. It's not as bad as it looks. Let's see, the Grasshopper needs about a day of repair. The Orion probably a day of repair. Firestarter about a day of repair. But he got a Mackie, which is incredibly rare. So we're going to put that together, and then we're going to see what else we get. Okay, so we got a Grasshopper part, we got the Mackie. We did not get any of the Juggernaut. I was hoping to get that. And we got some miscellaneous salvage. So the big news here is we got the Mackie. Again, I don't know if I would use that. We're going to have to see what we can do with it. Because it's a really old mech design. The Mackie was the first battle mech ever designed. So, at its time, it was a very lethal weapon that could turn battles all by itself just by showing up on the battlefield. Because no one had seen it before, but now we'll have to see if we can turn it into a viable mech. It is 100 tons, but it's really ancient. But it's really cool that we add a Mackie to our collection, because that's really hard to find. All right, we're going to need to do some repairs. Fortunately, we've got plenty of mechs, so that's not a big deal. All right, so our Grasshopper. What does it need? All right, so we've got to do our repair. Lost its Perseus arm. I think we have another one. Yeah, we got a Theseus arm. That actually improves the melee, so. Not bad. One day of repairs, no big deal. Let's see, Firestarter, one day of repairs. Orion, one day of repairs. No big deal. So we've got a Mackie available. Let's put that together and see what we could do with it. I don't know if I've ever had a Mackie to play around with in the mech bay, so let's see what we could do. As you can see, it's really old school. But let's see what we could do with it. Maybe with some parts, Star League parts, we can make this interesting. So first of all, we're going to take the jump jets off. No interest in a jump jet. Jump jets on an assault. It actually has an Eagle probe. I don't think we're going to have a use for an Eagle probe. Take that off. It already has double heat sinks, so that's good. It's got PPCs on it. We can probably upgrade those. So let's see what we can do first by putting in a ultralight engine. Okay, it frees up a lot of tonnage. So it's an assault. The durability is actually really high on this baby. Ooh, we get +4 Lance Resolve. That's pretty significant. Okay. So we're going to take off this LBX AC-10. And if you're looking at battles for this video, we're probably going to be done with, well, I know we're going to be done with videos here. So feel free to go to the next video if you're looking for mech battles. We're probably just going to reconfigure this Mackie, and then we're going to call it a day. So the Mackie doesn't have a lot of weapon slots, so we can actually go with Heavy Pharaoh here. I think. I don't think we need Case. So I think the Mackie is going to be best as a sniper. So let's take off the PPCs, and we're going to put on ER PPCs. All right, I like that. You know what? We're going to switch from Heavy Pharaoh to Light Pharaoh. We're going to need the weapon slots. Then we're going to go... put on a Gauss rifle. If it's going to be a sniper, it needs to have a Gauss. Alright, so let's put on our ammo for our Gauss rifle. Okay, we've got 17 tons remaining. Definitely going to put on an AMS. Just to increase the survivability of this frame. It's got really high melee, but it has really low speed. So I don't think that's going to work for us. But again, I think as a sniper platform, that's where this gets interesting. So, what if... Right, so we're going to move the AMS into the center torso. Put on a light Gauss. We're gonna have to take off the armor because we're gonna need this room, and then we're gonna take, we should have light Gauss ammo. There we go. Few tons of light Gauss ammo on this sucker. We're going to take off the Guardian ECM. Put on a PPC capacitor, which is going to increase the firepower for the PPC. Then we're going to put on we're going to change the double heat sinks. We're going to gonna make this a project, so we're gonna take out the double heat sinks. If this takes a while, I don't mind. So we're gonna put in the prototype double heat sinks. I can put two of those in the center torso. We can put one there. Let's put the PPC capacitor back on. Another prototype double heat sink, and another we're gonna leave it there. Okay, so what we've got here is this mech is gonna have two Gauss shots. It's going to have two ERPPC shots. I don't even know if having medium lasers makes sense here, because we're probably not going to get in close. This is going to be a sniper. So let's Guardian ECM, put that back on. And put the rest into armor. So this is going to be a beast. So what we have here is basically this is going to be a replacement for our Marauder. It's going to have an extra ton. It's going to have the ability to shoot an ERPPC, a ERPPC, a light Gauss rifle, and a Gauss rifle all at once for headshots. This could be a game changer. So it's going to take 24 days. That's fine. I don't mind letting that be built over a couple missions. We've got plenty of mechs to play with before that's ready. We also have this Marauder 2 that I've been putting together. They'll be ready in 8 days. That's going to be a beast right there. Missile beast. Alright, so very productive mission. I didn't think I would like that Mackie as much as I do, but it actually looks like a pretty nice mech. So that's going to do it for this video. Hope you enjoyed it. We got in a 5-skull mission, and we got some great interesting salvage. So we'll see you next time on Commando Gamings and Battletech Battles. Please subscribe and hit that like button. Talk to you soon.